welcome to 5-Minute Bedtime Stories with Miss Elaine. Tonight, we're going to read a story called Curious George and the Pizza. And it's not really a bedtime story per se, but anytime's a good time for some Curious George, right? I'm going to dedicate it to my friend Max, who lives right here in Pittsburgh, and who I usually get to spend time with each week, but we haven't seen each other in a while. And so I miss you, Max. The last time we were together, we were playing a pizza game, a Curious George pizza game, on the computer. So this book reminded me of you, Max. I hope you enjoy it. It's for you and all my other Curious George fans out there. Let's go out for pizza tonight, George, said his friend. At the pizza place, Tony the baker was getting the pizzas ready for baking. He flattened out a ball of dough into a large pancake and tossed it into the air. He spread tomato sauce on it, sprinkled it with cheese, and shoved it into the oven. Then the telephone rang. A fellow from the factory wants a large pizza delivered in a hurry, Tony's wife said. Okay, I'll get my coat, said Tony. George was curious. Could he make a pizza too? He jumped up onto the counter and took some dough. Uh-oh, what do you think's gonna happen? That George, he's always so curious. George pounded the dough into pancakes, and then he tossed them into the air with all four hands. Just like the baker did, right? That's what Tony was doing. So he's copying the baker. But then one of them plopped right into the middle of the table where a woman was sitting, and another landed on a coat rack. One fell on the jukebox. And then one landed smack on top of Tony's head. Who did that? He shouted. Oh, Tony doesn't look very happy, does he? Do you think Curious George is going to get into some trouble? Let's find out. George was scared. He ran out and jumped into a small truck to hide. What truck is he getting into? Is that Tony's truck? I see a pizza with pizza delivery man on the side. That customer is still waiting for his pizza, his wife called. You'd better hurry. They'll be closing the factory in a few minutes. I forgot all about it, Tony said. Oh no. Now he has to hurry to get the pizza there in time. Quickly, he packed the pizza in the back of the truck and drove off. George was trapped inside. Uh-oh. That's the truck that George was hiding in, remember? The truck sped up to the factory, but it was too late. The gates were locked. Oh no, Tony groaned. How will I ever deliver the pizza? He opened the back door of the truck, and there was George. So that's where you've been hiding, you bad little monkey, Tony cried. He reached out to grab George, but then he stopped. I've got an idea, he said. You're just the one I need. How good that George was a monkey. What is he using George for? Yes, monkeys are very good climbers. So even though the factory gates were closed, Curious George could climb right up and climb over top. He can get the pizza inside. Look at that, shouted the factory guard. A monkey delivering a pizza. Thanks, George, said Tony. You made up for all the trouble you caused. I'm going to make a special pizza for you and your friend when we get back. And that's just what he did. So now Curious George, and the man with the yellow hat get to enjoy a pizza together. I wonder what kind they made him. Huh. I know my friend Max likes pepperoni and sausage on his pizza. What do you like on your pizza, boys and girls? That sounds delicious. All right, let's sing our lullabies before we say goodnight. We're going to do Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star, followed by God Bless the Moon. Are you ready to sing with me at home? Great. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Up above the world so high, like a diamond in the sky. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Very good. Now I'm going to flip it over so you can see my moon, and we'll sing our second lullaby. I see the moon and the moon sees me. God bless the moon and God bless me. And God bless you boys and girls at home. I hope you enjoyed that story, and I hope you'll join me again real soon on 5-Minute Bedtime Stories with Miss Elaine. Good night.